A 2 cubic meter tank containing air at 15 degrees Celsius and 410 kilopascals is connected through a valve to another tank containing 2.8 kilograms of air at 32 degrees Celsius and 160 kilopascals. The valve is opened and the entire system is allowed to reach thermal equilibrium with the surroundings, which are at 22 degrees Celsius. What is the final equilibrium pressure of the air? Remember to solve this problem yourself before watching the solution to make the most out of this exercise. This is the first example for the ideal gas and compressibility factor 11-minute lecture video. The links to that video and other examples on this topic and the other lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. The final temperature of the air will be 22 degrees Celsius when it reaches thermal equilibrium. This means that if we look at our ideal gas equation, since air is an ideal gas, we see that we could find the equilibrium pressure if we find the total volume, the total mass, and the gas constant for air. The gas constant for air can be looked up, or like I mentioned in the main lecture video, you could use the universal gas constant R bar and divide by the molar mass of air. Either way, we get 0.287 kilopascals cubic meter over kilogram Kelvin. The total volume will be the volume of the first tank, which we have, plus the volume of the second tank. We can find the volume of the second tank again with the ideal gas equation. V is equal to mRT over P, and we have everything. Remember that we need the temperatures in Kelvin because of the units of our gas constant. The total mass will be the mass of the second tank, which we have, plus the mass of the first tank. We can find the mass of the first tank with the ideal gas equation one more time. M is equal to PV over RT, and again, temperature in Kelvin. With the total mass and the total volume, we substitute the values in our original ideal gas equation, the one for the entire system after the valve is open, to find that the equilibrium pressure is roughly 305 kilopascals. If you want to check out the other, more complex examples for this same topic, the main lecture video or other lectures of the thermo course and other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching!